Cube. At Big Data SV 2014 is brought to you by headline sponsors WAN Disco. We make Hadoop invincible and Actian, accelerating Big Data 2.0.
Okay, we're back, everyone. Welcome back to Big Data SV. We are live here in Silicon Valley covering all the big data action here on the ground, wall-to-wall coverage here, the Strata Conference happening right now behind us, getting started. And all the action is starting. We're wall-to-wall for 3 days. I'm John Furrier, the founder of SiliconANGLE, and I'm joined by my co-host Dave Vellante, the co-founder of Wikibon.org, and we're here for our next guest, CUBE alumni Chris Seeland, VP of Marketing and Business Development at Vertica at HP. Welcome back to the CUBE. Big data, you guys have big news. We saw it hit the wire. I want to get to the big news, but first got to ask you, your take on Silicon Valley and Big Data SV and Strata. What is the vibe this year, and what's different now than last year and the previous events?
I think I'm seeing more suits, and not just here in this room. You know, there's more business people in the room. There's certainly a lot of tech content and people who are looking to hear about, you know, what's a cool new technology, but I'm hearing a lot more talk to me about the business value, talk to me about the business case, talk to me about how this stuff makes money. And I think the other thing is also, and this kind of goes into our announcement, not trying to plug it, but maybe a little bit, but
yeah, we'll talk about it.
But you know, I think there's also people are starting to recognize that really being successful requires a combination of different technologies and tools and skill sets and so on and so forth. So we're really sort of seeing an ecosystem form here. So, which I think is a good thing.
That's a good thing, don't you think?
More absolutely.
Suits. I mean, people will grumble. You know, the T-shirt crowd will grumble. They were here, you know, from the beginning. But the good news is that means there's going to be some funding at the tail end of this,
so
we
can
keep innovating.
Buy nicer T-shirts.
Exactly. So let's talk about the news. So you guys had some news that you released. A couple pieces. You have the marketplace, and you have a partnership. Let's go into detail. Tell us, share with the folks the news.
Okay. Well, first of all, you know, yesterday we announced the HP Vertica Marketplace, which is a website. It's really a web property. It's part of the Vertica.com site. But it's basically where our users and our customers and our partners can get and share. First of all, they can download Vertica Community Edition, which for those of you not trying Vertica, do that. Start there. But all sorts of different tools and technologies that add value to Vertica. So Vertica is a platform. And so what we're doing is offering the various types of plugins, connectors, interfaces, and then some solutions that are basically either built for or built on Vertica as well. So including some of our own. We've seeded this with a lot of our own technology. We've also got a few partners in there as well. So
I want to drill down on some of the things you mentioned. Obviously business, you mentioned suits, which is, you know, basically saying a lot more serious, kind of go to market, what's good for the customer, new technologies. I got to ask you, because you guys were one of the rising stars in Vertica coming out of the, I would say, the first wave crop of startups in Gen 1 big data.
Yep.
Call it Gen 1 for the sake of kind of pegging a generation of real commercial, you know, the database piece all kicked in.
Right.
What's your take now? I mean, what do you think is going to happen? Because now we're going to see startups that were kind of in that Gen 1 class and Gen 2. You know, they got their $8 million Series A, maybe, $15 million. You know, we're seeing companies like Platform. I don't want to name names, but those are the kind of the general suspects, you know, Continuity. I mean, these are all friends of ours.
Right.
I'm using them as examples. They're doing well. But you're going to start to see people not make it. You're going to see people drop out of the race, so to speak. And we're going to be watching all that. So as the market gets more competitive, you really can't, you know, fake it till you make it or fake it till you're found out, right? I mean, is the old expression. What startups and what approaches do you think are winning and which ones aren't?
Well, you know, I've been, and maybe this is a signal how long I've been in this industry, I've always been a big fan of the sort of technology adoption lifecycle and the whole chasm group. And I think a lot of it is this whole market is kind of in the crossing the chasm phase, right? And when you get to that phase, you get past the early adopters, you get, you know, it doesn't mean that the T-shirts aren't still important. They are. But at the same time, you start hearing questions about how does this stuff make me money? And, you know, and what happens then is the buyers start shifting to the companies that can actually show and the technologies that can actually show how they've made money. And the customers can actually stand up and say, yeah, I used this and it worked this way. Or even, you know, or even it didn't work or I made mistakes, but I learned from my mistakes. So you start getting more and more focus on these customer stories. So it becomes about more than just the technology. And I think, you know, what happens is, I mean, you know, I'm not a venture capitalist, nor do I play one on TV, but it's, you know, there's a lot of investment. Yeah, I've seen the movie many times, too many times. But there's a lot of investment in early stage technology. And early on, a lot of companies get their initial funding without really deciding or figuring out what business problem they're going to solve or how they're, you know, how's this going to get monetized? And then what happens is that some companies crack the code and figure it out, or their customers figure it out, but others don't. And the ones that don't, then they have, you know, they struggle a bit.
Well, so I bring this up mainly because, you know, knowing, you know, we've known each other for a long time. You were an analyst. You kind of, you know what the landscape looks like. Again, you've seen the movie before. I really want to drill down on this because you're seeing a lot of people looking for navigation signals from the marketplace to where to go, what to do, right? Do I pivot? And what's happening? Is it real data? What's the signal? And then value to customers. So and this plays into kind of what you've spent a lot of time recently doing with the marketplace, which is to provide a forum for partners of HP, because you guys have a lot of muscle. I mean, you're on the five-year turnaround plan. That's well documented. We covered that at HP Discover. But ultimately, you've got a huge sales force, huge ecosystem. Tell us about how a company will play with marketplace. You have some incubation going on that's pretty much free. Can you just drill down for those guys out there? What do they need to know about this? What's your opinion on it?
Well, I think in our case, I mean, speaking for what we were trying to accomplish with the marketplace, yes, certainly we're looking to both leverage and build the ecosystem. I mean, you're right. I mean, HP has a massive ecosystem, which we are absolutely leveraging, and that's great. But also we're, you know, there's kind of a new ecosystem forming here around big data. So there's both the ecosystem we're leveraging and the ecosystem we're building, but it's really about helping the customers get more value. And, you know, this all grew off of our community, which we launched, depending how you count, because there was sort of a version one community and there was a version two community. The version two community has been live for a little over a year, and it's become incredibly popular for, you know, our customers and our partners and a lot of developers who build on Vertica to sort of share best practices and, I found a way to, you know, get the product running for this kind of solution. A lot of it's around solutions as well, where, you know, there was a survey recently done by a firm called Tech Validate where they went out and talked about 200 of our customers. They said, what are you doing with Vertica? Because, again, it's a platform, but, you know, and we found that, you know, there's a lot of people doing things like customer analytics. Well, how do I do better customer analytics? So how do I do things like you talked about our incubation program? We have something, it's called Innovations, is what our incubation program is. It's a section in the marketplace. We have this thing called Pulse, which is about sentiment analysis. So, you know, a lot of customers want to use Vertica to analyze sentiment, so they understand their customer sentiment better. Well, we built a module for that. And, you know, so there's stuff that we're building like that. We have a geospatial module. We have this thing called Distributed R that basically helps R scale, the R statistical language. But at the same time, there's stuff that we're building to help our customers, but there's stuff that customers are building and partners are building and developers are building, and we want them to be able to share it with each other. So that was really the logic here. So it's really about helping the customers get more value.
So, Chris, you were talking to John earlier about how, you know, you guys were early days of big data before it was called big data. You know, called it Gen 1, for the lack of a better term. And I wonder, so when we were at the Vertica User Conference, we talked to guys like Guess, Spill Games, the DNC was heavily into, what you got Yammer was another company. You know, we saw Facebook, of course, at Discover last November. How have your customers, as this whole Hadoop meme has come to fore, and you guys have you guys are early days. I think you were one of the first connectors, you know, into Cloudera, for example, before people were announcing connectors like every other week. How have your early customers evolved, and how has it changed the way that they look at data? And then I want to understand how that is, you know, sort of manifested itself in the marketplace.
Well, in terms of Hadoop, I mean, we've always felt that Hadoop is very powerful and complementary technology. And I think, you know, when I alluded earlier to understanding that you need a portfolio approach, I think the market's starting to realize that now too. I mean, certainly when we talk to our Hadoop partners, you know, they get it, that it's not necessarily the hammer to drive in all nails, but it has a lot of capabilities that are very powerful, very important, very complementary. When you look across our customer base, again, you can look at that same Tech Validate survey I mentioned that's on our blog. I put a post up about 2 weeks ago that all the results are public. But a significant, a sort of mid-double-digit percentage, I forget what the exact number is, of our customers are using Vertica and Hadoop together. So as far as Hadoop concerned, we see it as completely complementary technology, you know, Vertica plus Hadoop. And of course, the other announcement, which was actually made by MapR, was Vertica running directly on the MapR clusters. So, and we're going to be talking more about that. I know Colin's going to be in here talking about that tomorrow. So, but that's the other announcement, which wasn't actually our announcement, MapR's announcement. We've done a lot of work with those guys. But we're really working, you know, we've got our Haven platform that we announced last June. And our Hadoop strategy is to work across the board and work with everybody. I mean, there are subtle differences between there are certainly differences between the strategies of the different distribution vendors, and you know, but we're making it our goal to work across the board and mostly work for the success of our joint customers.
So to the point, you talked about the Tech Validate survey, you know, significant double digits, but that's not where it started, right? It started probably low single digits or zero. So it's interesting.
Well, you always got to start from somewhere.
Well,
right?
but I mean, Cloudera was 100%, right? So I'm saying you guys predated.
Right.
That whole piece of it. So I feel like the timing was fortuitous. I really feel like HP lucked out when it bought Vertica. At the time, I don't think HP really understood what it had, and then realized after a while, holy crap, we got this gem. And it took a while for HP to really, you know, begin. And this is sort of before you came in, so maybe you were the catalyst. But
of course. Sure, I'll take credit.
Yeah, but
he gets another title.
Yeah. Colin may have something else to say about that. He's here tomorrow.
But so a lot of people, right, Colin was there too. But so a lot of people will look at, you know, Hadoop, wow, that's really disruptive. Mm-hmm. It seems like it was a tailwind for you guys. So is that a fair observation? Is that a correct observation in your view?
So
are you now the new disruptors?
I've never really thought about it that way, but I think that's a very good analogy. I think you've really, you know, I think what you just said is important. Yeah. You know, it's definitely, you know, the other words, the rising tide lifts all boats, right? I mean, obviously, there's a lot of interest in Hadoop. Open source technology, you know, obviously kind of just the whole genesis of where it came from and all the people who are experimenting and, you know, learning. I mean, there's been a real groundswell there. And, yeah, we've benefited from the groundswell. Because I guess what I'd say is we've definitely made it a point to not go and try to fight a religious war and instead go figure out how we can leverage and how we can work with. And it has paid off for us, so thankfully.
Yeah, well, you don't have a legacy database business, right? I mean, it's sort of a new database business, right?
Yeah, I mean, we're definitely what you would call a new breed database company, if you will, or, you know, as we prefer to call it, an analytics platform. So, yes, absolutely.
So in the new marketplace, you guys have really tough. You know, we saw you guys at your I don't know if you want to call it developer, but your customer event you had in Boston.
Yeah,
very big names. We covered that extensively with the Cube coverage. They weren't like, you know, low end. They were really high end folks. I mean, big deal, big solutions. They're kind of stuck in the middle, so to speak, from a profile. I couldn't put my finger on them. They weren't pure developers,
right?
But they were cutting edge business folks who were basically driving DevOps and solutions. So is that a new, I mean, how are you reconciling that in marketing and you segmenting the market? Do you look at it, it's like, I mean, how do you define your developers first? Mm-hmm. Is it a new breed? Is it a modern era? I mean, this is something that's new kind of a new breed. Or is it the same as Hadoop?
Well, it kind of goes back to that original answer I gave you, which is that it's the person, and a lot of times it's led by a person in the organization that's trying to figure out how to get more value out of this stuff, that's been doing a lot of poking around and experimenting and, you know, poking at this and poking at that and trying things and testing. But now, you know, they're maybe getting pressure, or they're maybe recognizing, I think more in the latter case, they're recognizing there's an opportunity here, there's potentially a threat here. You know, there's an opportunity if you do it well, there's a threat if you don't. I think, you know, I often say, like I was on a panel earlier today, that, you know, big data is kind of like the new e-business. Remember like 10, 12 years ago, we used to talk about e-business, and everybody talked about e-business. And everybody said, well, you don't hear it anymore, right? And everybody said, well, it's overhyped, but it's fuzzy, but it doesn't mean anything. And I'm hearing a lot of the same things about big data right now. But what it is a signal that everything has kind of changed. That being good at using all of this different types of data, the volume, velocity, variety, is really what can give you either a competitive advantage or a competitive disadvantage right now, and companies are really trying to figure out how to leverage it strategically. So, and if you looked at our conference, we put the customers on stage, and that's really what we tried to do.
I'll try to ask the question again.
Okay.
So, profile of developers.
Yep.
I mean, try to be specific. Is it DevOps? I mean, do you have a finger on that? Do you know? Or are you just trying to get more data? Is it just all the general purpose web guys out there?
Okay, yeah, sorry. I think I maybe misunderstood your question a little bit. No, I mean, basically, they're trying to build big data-enabled solutions. And then we've also got a lot of developers who are building utilities and connectors for Vertica as well. But really, it's, you know, it's all around the how do I get more value out of this, but not just how do I get more value out of Vertica, but how do I get more value out of big data, and how do I actually solve problems? So we're a platform business as opposed to a solution business.
We're
encouraging our developers who have solutions, either they built them for themselves or they built them for their clients, to share them. And eventually they'll be able to market and sell them, by the way. Right now it's just free, but we will eventually have a path in the not too distant
future. So I guess the answer could be Vertica developers.
Yes, exactly.
Vertica developers.
That's a simple answer. Like, I guess I can give a simple answer. And there, you know, there's a parallel effort going on around Haven as well, too. So that we're also very much supporting, and that this is fundamentally a component of. I mean, there's Vertica developers, there's Haven developers.
Yeah, let's talk about
Haven.
Hold on. I want to get this, because Microsoft has a new CEO, and the big discussion there was they're trying to get developers that weren't weaned on the old Microsoft platform, because there's a whole new breed of folks that are used to the non-SQL, the Mongos, and the database, the data science, and the analytics, and the legacy mixed in there. So it's interesting. We're watching that. But we have some fans out there of yours. Tim Crawford. He says, ask Chris about the status and maturity regarding big data, both consumers versus the market, and have him talk about how Haven, second question, how Haven and Vertica is specifically taking a leadership position. So one, the maturity regarding big data, both customers versus the market.
Yep.
And then the Haven leadership position.
Okay. Well, I think to the first question, I kind of said that earlier, you know, I was talking about chasm model and all of that, but I think we're maturing. I think we're far from mature. I think we're really in the, what was the other book that Jeffrey Moore and those guys wrote? It was
Inside
like the Bowling
tornado.
Alley, the Tornado, Inside the Tornado. I think we're kind of in the tornado stage right now, right? But, and then when you're inside the tornado, that's what people look to guidance. They look to say, well, who's actually made money with this stuff? Hence our putting our customers on stage at our big data conference and showcasing those customers who are actually being successful. And then the second question was, since I'm giving very long answers,
how Haven
is
taking a leadership position. How Haven and Vertica, how HP Haven and Vertica, parentheses, is specifically taking a leadership position.
Well, the fundamental premise of Haven is to be able to, and I think this is something that HP really can offer in a way that really none of our, you know, competitors can match, the ability to basically help companies leverage all of their data and put it to use and, you know, turn it into a strategic advantage from, you know, we talk a lot about, and we've been as guilty as anybody, as segmenting the world into structured and unstructured data, but in reality, it's a continuum. Right, and a lot of the sort of new forms of data, the dark data out there, is really, it's not purely unstructured data necessarily, but it's also not traditional structured data. So it's the semi-structured stuff in the middle. It's the log files, it's obviously social media. And so between the combination of assets we have with Vertica, with Autonomy, with our security products, and then you start to combine that with the power of Hadoop and you wrap our services and our platform capabilities around there, that's what Haven's all about, is offering the ability to our customers and to our partners to really basically have a platform upon which they can leverage and monetize all of their data, all of these different forms, dark, light, structured, unstructured, semi-structured, and use it effectively. So that's really what we're trying to do.
So are you going to knock down specific use cases with Haven, or is it more, hey, here's the platform, who wants it?
We sell some of our own HP solutions into the markets we serve. Like we serve, you know, for instance, IT Ops, and we've got a product called Operations Analytics that's actually built on Vertica, and, you know, it's basically a Haven solution that we sell. But at the same time, we're also looking to our partners, hence the focus on partners at the marketplace, to build a lot of these solutions. Certainly a lot of the vertical market solutions, a lot of the horizontal solutions, you know, that's where, and some of what we're doing in the marketplace, some of what we've done will give a jump start. Like, it's funny, the Pulse module I mentioned before, the sentiment analysis module that we built on Vertica, we've built some demos, and we've actually got like a Tableau version, a MicroStrategy version, a Tipico Spotfire version. We got a bunch of different versions of the Pulse demo where we can show sentiment analysis. Every time we actually show it at a conference, because it's a really cool demo, everybody comes up to it and says, oh, you're a social media analytics company. And we're like, no, we're not a social media analytics company. We can do social media analytics inside of Vertica, but we're not selling you a solution. What we really want to do is have all, and we've got a ton of them, by the way, that are partners of ours, have all the social media analytics solution companies build their solutions on Vertica. And then, by the way, you know, when you start to talk about Haven, they can leverage some of the capabilities of Autonomy Idle, you know, so on and so forth. So obviously leverage Hadoop. So that's what we're really looking to accomplish.
Well, that's the yin and the yang of being a platform company, right?
Yes.
The good news is you're going after the multi-billion-dollar business. The bad news is it's like, okay, what are you?
Mm-hmm.
Right? And that's hard
work.
Well,
we're the big data platform, and we're the big data platform that helps customers, helps partners, you know, helps developers leverage all of their data, 100% of it, and that's really what we're trying to do.
So there's a lot of guys trying to be the big data platform, and there's clearly nobody has emerged as the big data platform.
Mm-hmm.
So why Vertica? What gives you confidence that you guys are going to sort of win that game, or at least meet your objective?
Well, again, you know, just to be clear, Vertica is a component of Haven, right? So again, you know, the Haven strategy is, as you know, in a lot of ways, certainly Vertica was pretty much there at the beginning, let's put it that way. I want to make sure that credit gets allocated appropriately, but we're a part of Haven. But, you know, the whole Haven platform acknowledges that it's not just Vertica. I mean, we obviously offer a very, very key component for doing very high performance analytics on very large volumes of data, you know, and that's really what we're all about. And now we've announced that we're doing, you know, more of a semi-structured data with a new FlexZone product, but at the same time, you know, we're not, you know, you're doing audio, video, pure unstructured data. Obviously, we're leveraging the capabilities of Hadoop. So again, it goes back to what I said earlier, that there's really, and I think it's what you're seeing with the suits in the audience and with the focus now on, let's hear what the customers have to say. The idea that, you know, I mean, these different tools and products and technologies, they all have their uses and they all have their benefits and capabilities. But to be successful, you know, it really requires an approach that's more business driven and looks at a portfolio of solutions and how can I put them together to be effective.
So given that, what's the go-to-market strategy with I guess, Vertica, mm-hmm. You know, specifically, but Haven generally, or maybe Haven specifically and Vertica generally?
Mm-hmm. Well, we're growing very, very rapidly. I mean, obviously, we're selling it as much as we can, and we're having, you know, we're seeing a ton of growth. I mean, obviously, I think we're doing pretty well in the market. I'm not able to get too specific about that, but we're doing really well. But at the same time, what we're really seeing the take up and what's really been exploding for us has been the growth of our, you know, our partnerships, both the ecosystem around the product, you know, of developers, hence what we're here to talk about, but then also our channel partners, many of whom are part of the ecosystem. You know, we've got our OEM partners, we've got our channel partners, we've got the global SIs, we've got, you know, obviously many of our customers are developing. So there's a whole ecosystem really forming around Vertica and around Haven, and that's what we're really looking to bring out and to grow and to encourage. And like I said, the whole marketplace announcement was about giving them a place to show what they've done, show what they've got, share it, get ideas, and you know, it's actually the marketplace, even though we announced it yesterday, it's been live for about 45 days or so. We had it sort of in preview mode for our community to kind of look at it, bang on it. So it's been up for a little bit, so we've already gotten some early feedback and people are really finding it useful, so we're really excited.
And the URL,
it. It's vertica.com/marketplace. So
great.
Yep.
Okay. I also shared it on the crowdchat.net/bigdatasv.
Excellent.
What are some of the things that you guys are looking at doing with the feedback? Give us some early indication of uptake. It looks great. It looks mm-hmm. clean. Any feedback on good, bad, ugly, where you're doubling down?
Good, bad, ugly, where we're doubling down? Well, yeah. We place a lot of credit or credence in the opinions. We have a customer advisory board. We're actually meeting in about 2 weeks out here. So we get them together biannually, and then we get together online I think monthly or bimonthly or something like that. So we talk to our cab a lot, but you know, we've got such a big customer base and it's grown so fast, we can't necessarily have everybody on our cab. So this gives us feedback to really, a mechanism, I should say, to get feedback from our much broader customer base. And so, you know, and we make adjustments. I mean, we're extremely customer driven. I think going back to one of the earliest questions you said is like, you know, what's really driven our success? I think it's really a focus on the customers more than anything else that's really, really helped us. And, you know, like I said, the developers are our customer, the partners are our customers as well. But I think that's really helped us out.
Explain to the folks out there, obviously you came in post Vertica acquisition, but mm-hmm. you know, you work closely with Colin, who's mm-hmm. been in the queue multiple times, one of the original guys at that startup. What is your take? Explain to the folks what's surprised you and what has been like a big game changer of the post Vertica impact to HP. Obviously this whole strategic Haven, mm-hmm. that umbrella. Kind of give some perspective, share your color around what that meant and what happened internally at HP around that and some of the benefits that's coming off that tree, if you will. What fruit is bearing off that Vertica root?
Yeah, well, I think that, first of all, you know, it's been great. I mean, I joined in August 2012. And, you know, it's funny because, like, I hear these stories about HP and it's like, I don't know that company. It's like, I know a company that is, you know, I mean, we're a growth business. We're focused on growing our growth businesses. We've identified big data as a huge growth opportunity. I mean, it's one of HP's big bets. It's certainly not the only one. There's cloud, mobile security as well. But, you know, it's a company that, and it's a company that most importantly is customer focused. And, you know, I think it's been driven right from the very top. I mean, anytime you hear Meg Whitman talk to an audience, she talks about being a customer focused company. And so it's been great. I mean, you know, you hear these things about things that may have happened in the past. I wasn't there for those things. But, you know, at the net is things are going really, really well. We've got a lot of competition. It's a very crowded, noisy market. But we're getting our piece of the market and probably and then some. And staying very customer-focused, building our partnerships, building our ecosystem. So, you know.
A question in the crowd. Finally, we're going to wrap up here, but I want to get this question in.
Yep.
Does HP leverage non-customers as part of their CAB, Customer Advisory Board, to counter the echo chamber factor, groupthink, or whatever people want to call it? I mean, also, your customer focus, that's, you know, I have no need to talk more about that. That's obviously,
yeah.
Everyone knows how important that is. But
yeah.
Do you look for outside perspectives to saying, hey, we might not be winning there? Is it a signal? Is it something to calibrate against? How do you calibrate that non-customer?
Well, we absolutely do. I mean, we get a lot of that through the community. And by the way, we also participate in a lot of other communities. You know, the Customer Advisory Board, as the definition would say, is customers. And it's people who actually use the product
heavily. No, there's no customers on heavily Customer Advisory Board.
Yeah, I mean, by definition, it's customers. Although there was one situation where, and I got to give Colin credit, where it was a division of a big company that wasn't quite as enthused necessarily. They're having some issues. And basically, Colin said, why don't you join our CAB? And by doing that, they basically had some input, and it sort of swayed them. So, you know, I'll let him sort of tell that story because it was really something he did. So it kind of sort of was what you said. But at the same time, yeah, we listen to the broader community all the time. I mean, you know, we're staying in touch with the analysts, obviously, who stay in touch with the customers to make sure we kind of get the feedback through that channel. But we talk to customers, prospects, the industry all the time. And that's what I'm doing at this event, and that's what we're doing is, you know, walking the floor, talking to people, and that's one of the most fun things.
I worked at HP back in the day, and all great companies talk to their customers, and then Customer Advisory Board, but a lot of the times it's the customers that you're not losing, but they're kind of giving you signals like, hey, you know, we would like to see some things, and maybe it's a customer satisfaction potential product issue.
Yep.
That's a barometer, right? So I'm sure you guys look at that, and I think that's a key input.
Absolutely. But, you know, as they say, and it's true, as you know, I'm an old CRM guy, it's if you basically address a customer with a problem is actually an opportunity. Because if you do a good job of addressing that problem, you get an answer. And truthfully, don't blow smoke. Give them an honest answer. Like, sometimes you can't solve the problem, or sometimes it might be to steer them in another direction, you know. And this is actually part of being part of a company that has sort of such a broad portfolio of assets. We can do that, you know. It can be painful at times if you have to sort of recommend something that wouldn't necessarily be. But if it's the right thing for the customer, that's really what we try to do. And long term, that actually does buy you, you know, I think we're living proof of it. It buys you more loyalty, it buys you more growth, and it buys you more success. Because if you make the customer successful, you're going to be successful.
And customers will stick with you in the long haul when you have that kind of relationship. Chris, final question. Bumper sticker of the event so far, obviously your vibe here. It's early on for Strata, Big Data SV. Encapsulate in your mind Silicon Valley, Big Data, the ecosystem, what's going on in Strata, what's happening here, bumper sticker, what's happening in the market right now?
Bumper sticker, I don't know if I'd want to say like more suits, less t-shirts, right? That'd probably get me run off the road around here in certain areas. But I think, you know, it's, I think we're still, I'd love to say customer success. I think we're still a ways from there. I mean, this is definitely a technology show still, but I think we're starting to get there. So I think, you know, maybe I'd say something about extracting the business value or figuring out the business value or, trying to figure out, you know, big data equals big money, something like that. I mean, and maybe that there. Does that work for you?
Yeah,
Dave perked right up. Maybe it's an equal sign or maybe it's an arrow, right? Big data, big money. And
big data, you know, big money, big data SV.
Yeah, and not just for the companies who are selling the technology, but the customers who are actually using it. That's what they're trying to figure out. So that's, you know, maybe there's that's my bumper sticker answer. How's that? So
big data, Chris Seelin, VP Marketing, BizDev at HP. Vertica, huge big data opportunity. It is a growth market, certainly. And again, I think it's just the beginning. I think we're coming out of the trough of disillusionment. I agree with you. Huge opportunity, big data, big money. Suits means progress. That means there's some real value, a lot of stakes at risk here, and big business opportunities also on the table. So this is theCUBE, Big Data SV, hashtag Big Data SV. Join our crowd chat. We're live. We'll be right back with our next guest after this short break. This is theCUBE.